Thank you. Is the rebate, Ms. Bricker, is the rebate system transparent right now, would you say?
The rebate system is 100% transparent to the plan sponsors and customers that we service. So the people that hire us, employers of America, the government, health plans, what we negotiate for them is transparent to them.
Mm-hmm. So that we can track the list price, then we can see the rebate, then we can see the net price, then we can see the savings that you pass along to the consumer. That's all completely transparent to the public.
It's not transparent to the public unless they are our patient.
Mm-hmm.
So
should it be?
We don't believe so.
Should it be trade secret? Is that the problem? Like proprietary?
The reason I'm able to get the discounts that I can from the manufacturer is because it's
a secret.
Because it's confidential?
Yeah, because it's a secret. What about if we made it completely transparent? Who would be for that?
Yes, we would support transparency along the entire chain. That's mm-hmm. the important thing, is if we have transparency all along from the list price all the way through to patients.
Do you all support that?
Absolutely not.
No, but you can't, because then it'll end up hurting the consumer.
It will hurt the consumer.
Yeah, it'll hurt the consumer to have transparency.
Will hurt the consumer, Congressman, because prices will be held high.
I'm not buying it. I think a system has been built that allows for gaming to go on. And you've all got your talking points. Ms. Tregoning, you have said you want to guarantee patient access and affordability at least 10 times, which is great. But there's a collaboration going on here. I know there's this going on too, but the system is working for both of you at the expense of the patient. Now, I reserve most of my frustration for the moment in this setting for the PBMs, because I think the lack of transparency is allowing for a lot of manipulation. I think the rebate system is totally screwed up, that without transparency, there's opportunity for a lot of hocus pocus to go on with the rebates, because the list price ends up being unreal in certain ways, except to the extent that it leaves certain patients holding the bag. Then the rebate is negotiated, but we don't know exactly what happens when the rebate is exchanged in terms of who ultimately benefits from that. And I think we need more transparency. And I do not buy the argument that the patient is going to be worse off, the consumer is going to be worse off, if we have absolute transparency. I think, just to get the lobbyists in the room to shudder a little bit, I think the PBM should be utilities. Or converted to nonprofits, or something. I know when you started out, I understand what the mission was originally of the PBMs. It's a complicated industry. You need an intermediary to assemble all the information on both sides, to weigh in, to assemble the bargaining position so that you can get the best price. And in the early days, that was a good argument. But now things have gotten out of control. You're too big, and the lack of transparency allows you to manipulate the system at the expense of the patient. So I don't buy the argument that the patient and consumer is going to get hurt if we have absolute transparency. And if we can't get it from a for-profit entity like the PBM, then we ought to look at other ways of doing it, including having the government get into this space and compete in providing that important function. And with that, I'll yield back my time.
Chair now recognizes the gentlelady from Illinois, Ms. Schakowsky.